I don't want that.
And I have finished fragments. So let's go.
Welcome to this talk. It's just PyCon Postgres. I think that you know Postgres SQL. If you don't know, there's a lot of books. Understand? It's a great software. It's not an ERP or a new language, just a database. It's a powerful database. Firstly, I'm just Stephane. So you can contact me on this address, stephane@wirtel.de. My Twitter site is on Twitter, and I have a small website where the blog is just there. About the schedule, what will we learn today? Just some stuff. PsyOpg, Alembic, Postgres, PeeWee, Multicon, Python, SQL, PeeWee, of course, and Python. I don't know what that. What's a Python? It's just a small programming language. No, I think because syntax, interpreted, multi-pattern, dynamic typing, multi-threading, and garbage collector. Just Postgres. It's just a story. And that one is really interesting because we will have a new version before Christmas. In the different points of Postgres, we will learn the extension and, of course, the framework and wrappers and the procedural languages. Because the talk we discuss about this one. About the framework and wrapper is just a way to use an external resource from Postgres. Example, you want to use Twitter or your favorite RSS feed because you want to. Example, you can use the file system or the process. You want to interact with your system. Sorry, my native English is too strange. And so you can discuss with the external resource. For the PL, just procedure language, we will see some straight procedure. We will see that we have some step languages. Example is PL and PLPGSQL. And for the unsafe language, we have PL Python, C, PL Benhite, and of course PL Pro. It's just a good word. Do you know that there is a standard for Python? For Python about the database. Yeah, there is the DBAPI 2.0. It's just a specification, a pack, where there are two concepts: just the connector and the cursor. The connector just to discuss with the database, open a connection to the database, with TCP connection, or just with the unit socket. Kind of the transaction in the state, internal state, just a commit, you create a new transaction, you commit it, or just roll back if you have an error. And of course, we can use some SQL queries. For the connection, the DBAPI explained that you have five functions to respect. You can see the connect function, just to create a connection, the close to close it, the commit and the rollback to play with the status of the transaction. And if you want to create a cursor, that stuff is really interesting. To discuss with the database, create a SQL query, or just create a new database. That's my example. So it's you import the driver. The driver has to respect the DBAPI. You have the connect function, you give the parameters, and just that you can play with that. You have the rollback if there is an exception. And you can commit and, of course, you close the connection. With that, that's really interesting, but it's just a dummy card. Now we can create a cursor. For the creation of a cursor, we have to use an existing connection. Firstly, you see the example. From the connection, then create a cursor with this function, cursor, of course. If you specify a name to this cursor, you will use several side connectors. In fact, if you have a large volume of data, the data will stay on the server and not in the memory of the client. That's a big difference. Example, 1 million of rows. For the cursor, we have five functions just for the six functions for the cursor. Execute, fetch all, the close, and the rest is just when you want to use it, you call it for fetch one and fetch name. Execute, you can use it for the creation, for update, read, delete, and just for the set. Fetch goal will fetch all the requests from the DSL and the closer will close the connection, the cluster. Do you know a language PHP? Do you know the SQL in JSON? There is no that with that type of PHP because DBRPI2 just create in the execute function string formatting for the request. And you can see the different way, different ways for the string formatting. So example where you create the connection, create the cursor, just execute a set where you give, we pass an argument, and there's no D person D or S, just person S. And we fetch the result error by commit or close. Okay? That's really difficult. So we have a library for the when we want to discuss the Postgres, PyCon2. For me, it's the most evaluated library for Postgres. There is a lot of different
You said you think it's the most...
Most important.
Thank you. Well,
So, introduction. Just Postgres. PyCon2 is based on PQ. Do you know what's a PQ in French? The paper in the table. First time I see
PQ. That's why that's okay.
So, DBRPI compliant, multi-thread, thread safe, coroutine. If you want to use the listen and notify of Postgres, you can use it as well. Of course, full and synchronous. And support all the data type of Postgres, JSON, HStar, JSONB, and the rest, everything. Okay. Of course, support supported with Python 2.5 and Python 3.5. The cursor, say, that's a DBRPI compliance component, but in this case we have that. Okay? But SQL request is just some example. For best example, we have this SQL, PyCon2, reload the PyCon2 library, just use the connect function from DBRPI, create a cursor, execute something, we can roll back in case we have an exception. And the commit or just create the connection. Okay? And PyCon2 implements a context manager. Instead of that, we have this code. We close everything. If there is a problem with the connection will be closed. If there is an error with the SQL query, there will be a problem. So, next point. Object creation mapping. What's that? From Wikipedia, can we? Iteration mapping is in computer science programming technique for converting data between incomputable text systems and object-oriented programming language. In brief, just map a business class on a scale table. Just that. A method for hard-modified delete and search of course we can. Another example of a small ORM, object-oriented mapper, PIMI. Do you know PIMI? No? Just very funny. Because just because the Jenkins documentation is really interesting to read if you want to learn something. The code is one file. The project is just in one file. Support all versions of Python, CMWD, and really, if you want to hack it, to have a new type or your own extension. That's really good. Example of the connection, just create a connection where two PostgreSQL database, in this case just demo, and you can give some, in this case with demo, we use a Linux socket with the local user, no TCP connection. Okay? PIMI is based on the model on the data mapper pattern. In this case, we can create different. In this case, two models, the address, the contact. You know that with Django, it's the same thing. To create the address object with a street, zip code, and country. But for the contact, you can have
a method, it's a foreign key. I don't know for it angle, but in SQL Alchemy, it's a foreign key with a relation with an integer. Okay? For the creation of the table, just create table. For the transaction, just create a transaction. The connector will give you a transaction. You can use it for a commit or just a rollback. You have the context manager. For the creation, we can use the create method. Just your model, dot create. We'll give the details and arguments. And there's no insert. No. For the read, you have the get method. You can execute, you can pass some condition. There's a create folder in the system. You have the select, you have the for the update, just create a transaction, get the record, change the name, like you see the first name, and save it to that. For the delete, same thing. Firstly, you can select the record and just delete and send. Or if you want to work on the entire collection, just select the record. So, SQL Alchemy, we have PWE, just for the newbie, and SQL Alchemy for the expert, master, object creation, master. So, alright, that's a matter of objection. That's not the case for SQL based on Python, it's not true. With this tool, you can support Oracle, Postgres, MySQL, SQLite, SQL Server, so. I don't want to be a try. So, the connection. Create a connection to Postgres. You have some models. Okay, address, containers, tools. It's the same example of with PWE, just in this case I translated to SQL. Create a database. You have a session, instead of a transaction, you have just a session where you can add every all your objects and just commit, or just the flush is an intermediate commit the database, our strong checkpoint. How to create, just with you have a session, you create your address in memory, your contact, you have the contact, automatically, SQL Alchemy will have the address the session, and during the commit, we'll create the rows in the database. So, the read, just you have the session, you just use a filter by function with your parameter, and that's the same thing to the rest. For the update, okay, just select the record and modify it. In this line, in this example, we had You take the record, change the attributes, just add it into the session, automatically the system will detect if it's a creation or just an update. Because in fact, in the contact you have an ID. If this identifier is just it's none, it's a new record, it's not none, it's a new update. So for the delete, we have that example. Okay. Not really important. Okay, we have PWE, SQL Alchemy. I don't want to speak about styles, but just about alembic migration. How do you make a migration with a SQL, some SQL files? With styles, or how do you do it? In SQL, you can use alembic. It's based on SQL Alchemy, by the creator of SQL Alchemy. You have an environment, so if you know Git, it's the same thing. You have the first migration is just a status zero, level zero, and you can create a new chunk set. For each chunk set, you have the parent and the set in the set. So to create the migration, just go in your project directory, create with alembic in it the directory migration, and you can create a revision. With the revision, you can see the upgrade and the downgrade. We modify the schema for the next version. The downgrade, we remove the new modification. And with Alembic, of course, you can use the SQL key library. Another example when I just add new column in the head user table, just like in the previous example, I click on the table. In this case, I just add the new column. After that, you can see that we have in the versions directory two files, the bootstrap and the password. So if you want to modify it, then. So, imagine that you are using, you have your project with your models, and you want to use them in your migration. You can use them. Just create a session, use a session with your model. In this example, just I want to create a Wi-Fi user in a hotel from the list of my contacts. Okay, just a small example. And of course, you have a command line. So you see, you have the revision to create a new revision. You have create command just to pass from the level 0 to the level 2. You can give an iteration. Or two, a plus two, minus one. You can downgrade to come back to the first version of your schema. You can see the current version, and you can have the history. So, I think it's two. You have the ledger. I want to speak about multicurrent. Multicurrent is just Python wrapper of the frame button wrapper of Postgres. You can see the project, and multicurrent is really useful because you actually can use it just because you want to discuss with Twitter, SS, with CSV files, file system process, PostgreSQL, Oracle, MongoDB, SQLite, everything. You can create a connector for everything. Okay? With that, you can use it in during a migration from one system to a second system, another, you can use it just for the migration. It's not needed to create an exploring works script for that. You can use it directly from Postgres. In fact, from Postgres, just create a table, I don't know, contacts, the new contact table in my database, and you can import the contact from the remote database. Why multicurrent? Because when you want to create a frame button wrapper with C, that's very funny. Okay? It's just for the Mongo, I think that I'm here. But with multicurrent, yes, you can use it there. If you want to use multicurrent, just firstly create this extension. Okay? Secondly, just create a virtual server. In the example, I create a server. I use the multicurrent wrapper, and I'm going to use this wrapper for the RSS field. I just create a virtual frame table, I give the parameters. The publication date, the description, the title, the link, and the parameter for the server. Just http://www.python.rss.xml. And the result is, okay, you can make it so you can do this. And of course, you have the result in your PostgreSQL instance. So, a more advanced example with Odoo. I don't know if you know Odoo. Odoo is an ERP. I was a former employee of Odoo. And I think it's a good example. Because sometimes some customer wants to use Odoo as an external resource for Postgres. In this case, I just generate from Wrapper wrapper. I give the pass the endpoint for Odoo with the parameter, just with the connection. And the execute method, I can execute. Okay. With the migration of Postgres, a frame wrapper is in read and write mode. In the last version, and the whole version of Postgres is just in read mode. the example with the project for data wrapper, I create my wrapper, my server, just create my frame table with different parameter, and it can do a select. So we have PyCon. PyCon is just a language embedded into Postgres. You can use PyCon 2 or PyCon 3. You can use your favorite libraries from PyPy, for example, NumPy, Equap, everything. Okay. Yes.
If you prefer to use PHP,
SQL, why not? I prefer to use PyCon because I know PyCon. I don't know PHP SQL. And the last point is just interested. Because PyCon is a link to the library of Python. You have Python, it's a library, it's not just a binary, it's a real library. And we can compile it with Postgres. So with PyCon, how to install it? Just create extension, PyCon U or PyCon 3 U. For if you want to use Python 2 or Python 2. So an example, I create a new title, new function, just a title, and in the source code, it's just a string here. Yeah. Between the dollar, you have a string, and this string will be compiled by the Python interpreter, directly. And in this case, I can extend Postgres. Can execute some function, example, this queues with the TARDIS. We have a mapping for the multi-types. Postgres on the left, Postgres on the right, Python. So you can see that everything is there. For the custom types, we have the date. For the list, we have the list and interest. If you want to debug build Python, don't use the print. Because it's not very useful. But PyPython will provide some functions to have some message in your logs. Okay? You can use notize, debug, or an advanced example of PyPython. With this function, I'm going to create, I will interact with my Linux system, and I would like to have the person. The CPU and the memory which off process. Okay. I created my function. So this function will have a field, mean bigger, and we return a table with a field, a CPU person, and a memory person. And I will use scarcity. Okay? Just use that, compile, and you can use it. Example, Postgres provide a PHP state activity. You can have the PI, the peer of your process, and you can have to the system the memory, the CPU percentage of this process. So PyCon, just attention, is unsafe, it's no sandbox. Yeah, you can remove a file. That's right. That's a bit difficult to maintain because you don't have a print, you don't have to use the log system. But GBM software will not be your best friend. So, you cannot use a virtual ARM, and you have to use the super user privileges. And for the ID to follow, treatment of the result, you can have your business logic, you can have new feature, CSS title. You can use it with the triggers, you can use your XML leaves, and for access to the database. And of course, there's a book on the booth of second volume. And thank you. Three short. Do you have a question? No? Okay. My wife is thinking, very, very.
We have some Ruby developer.
No question?
Sure.
Tomorrow we can start that project.
Okay. I have a question. For the creating a foreign data wrapper, can you go through a couple of different ways of using authentication when you're actually creating that wrapper class? Yeah. So if you have to try and get through some server hijinks and authentication, that's all good. Is it easy to create ways to put in username and password if you have to connect to a foreign server for your foreign data wrapper class?
Yeah.
Yep.
I have a question. What's the performance of the external on that wrapper?
Depends on how remote they are, I guess. And your progress when you create a new connection, progress will create a new process to manage this connection. Okay. And the Python will be embedded in this process. And in fact, there's no connection between Postgres and Python. We will use the binding. You will have a problem if you have a computer with a pre-computer. In this case, the process will be